soon as he thinks it costs too much. Sir, 50 cents, sir. Sir, can I clean your car window, sir? Sir, 50 cents, sir. Sir, just 50 cents. Can I clean your car window, sir?
Oh,
you guys again. Shoot. Shoot, go away. I don't have time. Go, go.
Thank you, MC Master 70, fellow Toastmasters, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening.
Good evening.
Now, the story that I'm going to tell you today is something very close to me, something very interesting. It was last year, a very fine morning. I was sitting on my bed. Close it. I could see sunshine right out of the window. Right sunshine. And suddenly I hear someone snoring. And I saw, and who? It was my wife. Most of you married men will do understand that. Why got so scared? That is something very usual for me. Like any other usual day. Went to the washroom, I got myself ready for the work. I sat in my car, I was driving by, listening to the radio, to the music. And I stopped by the signal. I could see boys just selling things, stuff, selling stuff on the signal. Suddenly a boy came to me and he said, sir, 50 cents, sir, please let me wash your car. Sir, 50 cents, only 50 cents, sir. And this time I was like, okay, okay. You can wash this time. You have been ahead of it. Seriously, you can wash this time. It was when he washed my car windows and I was going past by to my work. Now there, I'm sitting on my office desk, doing my work patiently, comfortably. Nothing else to do, nothing to worry about. And suddenly, the phone rang. I picked up the phone. So,
hello.
And from the other woman, it was my wife. And like every other conversation, the conversation started with sweet, powerful, abusive words, which I cannot say yet. And yes, it ended with sweet, powerful, and again, abusive words that I cannot say yet. She was very, very, very angry on me. And she was like, where are you right now? Come right to this place. I have a flat tire right now, my car has a flat tire. Come here right now, I want you right now here. And like every other good husband, I said, yes honey, I'll be there. Just wait for a moment, wait 15 minutes and I'll be there. I went out of my house. The place was nearby. So I just thought, I should go by a walk. I should walk there. And I was walking by, and I saw the car, my wife, and she was looking at me like, honey, where have you been? And there I was not looking at her, I was looking at the car. Honey, I cannot see any flat tire. All I can see is your flat face. She's like, unlike you, there was this one good guy, one handsome guy, who came and helped me. Unlike you, like you were always there. And now, there I was wondering, I was thinking, a young, handsome guy helping my gay wife? Why? Why is it so? So I decided, let's get in the car and search for this young, handsome, kind guy. Now there was my wife, sitting in the car. Around. There I saw in the corner, a young, handsome guy sitting right in the corner. His back was towards me. And there my husband, this is the guy. This is the guy I told you about. This is the kind guy who helped me. I'm like, who is this guy? And when that guy turned his face, it was the same young guy who used to come to me every other morning to say, sir, 50 cents, sir. Tell me what you want. 50 cents, sir. Let me clean your car windows. I was amazed and shunned by what I saw. Now there was a time I was like happy, and then on the other side, I was so sad. I was happy because I helped him that day, but I was sad
because I was very late in helping him. I couldn't help him much more faster, much earlier. I could have helped him much more faster. The guy knew was Ahmed. Ladies and gentlemen, never ever underestimate the power of kindness, a kiss of love, an eye full of affection, a kind touch. Little acts of kindness can turn someone's life up all around. The best portion of a person's life is are those little, memorable moments or unmemorable moments that a person do for someone for no reason. Life gave me a lesson that day. Give me a lesson that little acts of kindness, no kindness, no matter how small or big they are, they matter a lot. No matter for whom you do it, no matter for what you do it, no matter how you do it, they mean a lot. Little act of kindness. There's an Ahmed in each and every one of you. It's up to you to go look inside you, to search deep inside you, and try to find it. Over to you.